Hey everyone, this is Nick, and I just wanted to share a post in gratitude to everybody who has subscribed to my channel. It has been over 1,000 days since I've started this YouTube channel, and I wanted to sort of track my progress in terms of how long it took me to reach 100 different subscribers. So I thought a sort of modified waterfall chart might be a really cool data visualization to use to help me sort of visualize how long it's taken me to reach those 100 subscriber milestones. So here's what the waterfall chart looks like here in PowerPoint. It's a default chart type that you can use in PowerPoint and Excel. And you can see right here along the x-axis, the horizontal axis, I have the number of subscribers in buckets of 100. So 100, 200, 300, etc. And then along the y-axis here, the vertical axis, we have number of days. So right here, this this bar right here says 776. It took 776 days to acquire my first 100 subscribers. Now around 200 is when I started publishing a little bit more in terms of regular videos with narration and some content. And so that's when I started receiving or seeing these fewer number of days between the time it took me to reach 100 subscribers. So it took me 125 days to get to 200 subscribers. And then it took me 86 days to get from 200 to 300 subscribers, 43 to get from 300 to 400, 52 days to get from 400 to 500, and now 36 days to get from 500 to 600. Yesterday, I reached 600 subscribers, and at the time of this recording, I have 603 subscribers. So I hope that you will hit that subscribe button and hit the bell next to it to get notified every time I post a tutorial in data design, PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. But I did want to show you how you could make this. So this is how you have to set your data up. I have, my data set up over here in my Excel chart right here. And so you can see right here, this is my sort of subscriber bucket. So I have zero. This is when I started, and I started October 2019. And then in groups of 100, 200, 300, that's going to be my horizontal axis. I just have these dates here for some reference. And then I wanted to calculate the days between 100 groups. And so all I had to do to get this is type a formula. Type equals this cell right here, B3 minus B2. And when I enter that, that's going to calculate the number of days between these dates here in B. Now, all I have to do is copy this formula down, and Excel is responsive. It knows exactly where I want to pull the subtraction from. So here on this day, it's going to say B8 minus B7, and that was 36 days. So let's go ahead. And what I'm actually going to do is I'm going to go ahead and copy these two. I'm going to hold down Shift. I'm going to copy these two columns. I'm going to push copy, and I'm just going to have these over here on the right because I'm going to have to copy this into the chart. And I'm actually going to get rid of that first row. So I'm going to push Control X and then Control V. And so now this is going to be the source data for my chart. So I'm going to go ahead and copy this so that it lives on my clipboard. And then over here on my new slide, I'm going to say Insert, and we're going to go to Chart. And then down here, you can see that waterfall is a default chart type in PowerPoint. So I'm going to go ahead here. I'm going to click on this. And now it gives me sort of the default chart type. But right now, since I copied my source data, I can go ahead and push Control V. And then I'm going to go ahead and get rid of rows 8 and 9. I don't need those. Now it's a little bit weird here because I'm using, my version is actually a modified waterfall chart. It's not a traditional waterfall chart. Usually a waterfall chart has a total here, a start point, and a total over here at the end point. So I'm not using that in that way. I'm just kind of calculating the number of days between I get to this 600 mark each other. If I wanted to sort of update this chart to give a total of 600, I definitely could do that. But I'm not going to for this one. So in order to edit some of these, I'm going to go ahead and actually just delete the legend. I'm going to go ahead and delete the title too of this chart once I can get in there. We don't need the title because I'm just going to use that as a text box. Let's go ahead and drag so that this goes all the way over. Now, typically, this is this first bar and this last bar serve as sort of a total, and you can see why these things have kind of messed up. So what I need to do is just right-click on the bar and say Clear Total. I'm going to go down to this bar here and say Clear Total, And now you can see all of my days have stacked up here. Now, if I wanted to make some adjustments to this, I could go ahead and let's see, delete the axis line. I'm gonna go ahead and delete my grid lines. I don't really need those. Let's go ahead and just, let's see. Sometimes these default waterfall charts are a little tricky. I'm gonna go ahead and increase the font size here, and let's go ahead and make the font this color, the same blue. Let's go ahead and update this to 14, size 14. We'll bold the y-axis, will go up to 14, and we'll bold the x-axis here too. All right, and maybe I'll just drag this a little bit down here. If I wanted to have a title along my chart here, what I might do is go up to the chart design elements and we'll say axis title. And then right here, I'll just type in YouTube subscribers. Maybe we'll update the font on this as well. Let's go to size 14. I like to drag this over so that it lives. Oops, I guess you actually can't drag those over when you do those inside the chart, but that's okay. If I wanted to delete this and just put a text box underneath that axis, I could also do that. And then I could also put a title onto the chart, and I could put that right here on the top too with a text box. So I'm just gonna go ahead and insert a text box right here. And YouTube, so I would actually subscriber growth over time. I would make that a better title at some point here, just like my title over here on the original one. The number of days between acquiring every next group of 100 subscribers has significantly decreased over time as I post videos more regularly. You always want to make sure that you have a nice title that gives the point of the chart. Basically, I want to be able to read the title of the chart and know exactly what I'm supposed to get from the chart. Without sort of having to sort of really scour the chart and look for those details. So I hope that you enjoyed this video. Go ahead and try your own waterfall chart with this type of data. Thanks again for subscribing to my channel. I hope you go ahead and hit the bell next to it to get notified every time I post a data design tutorial in PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. Remember, you don't need to be a professional designer to look like one with the software that you use every single day. I hope you have a great day, and I'll see you next time.